Welcome back to our class. Very good morning. Now, in this class, we are going to learn circles part 12. So, very short questions and long questions completed within previous 11 parts. Now, in this part 12, we are going to start 4 mass questions. Okay, we have 20 questions, 4 mass questions already. So, from 4 marks, 1 4 mass question from this chapter. Okay, remaining 2-7 marks that is completed, 2 very short questions that are also completed. So thank you for watching our classes regularly. If you are newly watching, please subscribe and click bell button. Okay, 4 marks questions. So actually it consists 22 marks circles. Yes? Yeah, very good. So taking first question, 4 marks question. If the length of tangent drawn from capital P to the circles x square plus y square minus 4x minus 6y minus 12 equal to 0. X square plus y square plus 6x plus 18y plus 16 is equal to 0. Or in the ratio 2:3, then find the locus of P. Okay? So in first year locus, okay, we have studied, yes? Yes, there. Locus means immediately we have taken the point P is x1 comma y1. Do you remember that? Yes, very good. Okay, question correct or not? Yes. Okay, here what is the statement? The length of tangent. What is length of tangent? In the previous part we learned. 2 mass questions. Yes, very good. Root S11. Yes. If circle is S is equal to 0, the length of tangent is root of S11. Okay, first I am writing solution step by step. Very simple. I just tell you one question. As easily, I will give you one more question for your practice purpose. So then you can improve your skills. So first letter P x1 comma y1 is a point of required locus. Then I am making P. The locus of P is x1 y1. What are the given equations? Circle equation. First circle taking as S. That is, what is the first equation? Equation x square plus y square minus 4x minus 6y minus 12 is equal to 0. And the second circle equation I am taking as S dash. Okay. First circle equation I am taking as S. Second circle S dash. If one more is there, you can take S double dash like that. So, second circle equation S dash, what is that? Please tell me. Yeah. X square plus y square plus 6x. Yes. Plus 18y plus 26 is equal to 0. Okay. So, locus of point taken as x1, y1 and given circle equation S and second one is S dash. Now, coming to the question. What is the question? The length of tangent. Length of tangent what? Root S11. So, for first circle, length of tangent is root S11. For second circle, length of tangent is root S-11. Okay, what about the length of tangents of so-and-so are in the ratio 2:3? Okay, so given that lengths of tangents are in the ratio. What is the ratio? Is 2:3. So what are the ratio of tangents length? Tangents are root S11 and second tangent is root S-11. The ratio of these two. This is the first circle length of tangent. This is the second circle length of tangent. So the length of tangent ratio is equal to given as 2:3. First, I am just simplifying these two. So ratio means what? In two ways you can say. Product of extremes is equal to product of means. Otherwise, ratio means what? Simply root S11 by root S-11 is equal to 2y. And do cross multiplication. 3 into root S11 is equal to 2 into root S11. Whatever you say. Directly also it can write. Can I write directly? Yes. Okay. Product of extremes. 3 into root S11. 2 square root. Now what am I doing? Yes, I am going to do squaring on both sides. Squaring on both sides. So obviously 3 square becomes what? 9. 3 square means 9. Root S11 square means only S11. And is equal means is equal. 2 square means, okay, if you do any mistake here, be careful, total will be wrong. So here, to remove the square root, we are doing squaring on one side. By squaring, 3 square becomes 9, root S11 square becomes root S1, so only S11. Similarly, 2 square means 4, root S11 dash square also becomes only S dash 1. So what is S11 for the first circle? So 9 into S11 is x1 square plus y1 square minus 4x1 minus 6y1 minus 12 and is equal to 0, right? Okay. And after is equal next to 4 is there. 4 into S11 dash means second circle. X1 square plus y1 square plus 6x1 plus 18y1 plus 26. Okay, by simplifying this, we can get the answer. Very simple. So now tell me 9x1 square. 9x1 square. 9 into y1 square. 9y1 square. 9 into minus 4. Yes, minus 36x1. 9 into minus 6. Minus 54y1. 9 into 12. Minus 108. Is equal. Now, 4 into x1 square. 4x1 square. Plus 4 into y1 square, 2y1 square plus 4 into 6, 24x1, 4 into 18, 72y1 plus 4 into 26, how much? 4 into 24, 4 to 8, 104. So bring all terms to left side, okay? 9x1 square plus 9y1 square minus 36x1 minus 54y1 minus 108. Bring that side, minus 4x1 square, minus 4y1 square, minus 44x1, minus 72y1, minus 104, will be equal to 0. So all are like positive terms, whenever you bring to left side, it becomes negative. Now see the x1 square terms, here plus 9s are there, here minus 4 are there. So subtract 4x1s from 9x1, you can get 5x1 square terms. Similarly, y1 square terms. Okay, here 9 positive are there, here 4 negative are. Subtract 4y1 from 9y1 becomes 5y1 square. And x1 terms here minus 36 are there, here minus 24 are there, totally negatives. So here 36 are 24, totally 60. So totally 60 x1 terms are there. Next, what about y1 terms? Here 54, here 72. So 2, 4, 6, 7, 5, 12. So minus 126 y1. What about constant terms? 108, 104 becomes 212. So it is equal to 0. Okay? So almost we have completed the locus of the point. Therefore, finally, last step. Is there any step? Anything common? So nothing common. Therefore, locus of point P is. Now write down without x1 by 1 means 5x square plus 5y square minus 60x minus 126y minus 212 is equal to 0. Yes, this is the locus of point. What do you mean by locus? In first year we study it. Anybody? Locus means very simple, it is the set of some points. So because of it satisfies several points this equation. Okay. If you have more information, locus part 1 by Nagaras. Please watch that video. You can get full clarity. If you have again any doubt, because of this is the second year, so most probably we give importance to second year problems and concepts. Okay, step by step. Many of you thinking about some questions you are not telling from the textbook. So again I am saying, many times I have told, So no need doing all problems from the textbook, because of up to 10th class is different, intermediate level is different. In intermediate, within the short time, very easily we can get the score. Okay, only one technique, follow me what I am saying. If you have any doubt, you just revise the previous question paper, see the previous question papers, we can understand. Okay, what type of questions are can get in the exam. Okay, only 7 marks questions important only we can expect, 4 marks also. And moreover, if anything is from non-important, we can leave in the choice. But 2 marks questions, we should learn all type of 2 marks questions. So circles is there. So from the chapter circles, do all 2 marks questions. Means if you know the concepts, you can do the all 2 marks questions easily. Yes? Shall we go to next problem? Any doubt? See, first we should know what is length of tan. Immediately you can remember that is root S11. Root S11. So here two circles are there, another circle like this root S11 dash. So applying given statement, what is the given angle? Squaring on both sides, simplify, get the answer. That's it. Okay. So okay, for your practice, I will give you a second question, same type of question. The lengths of tangents from T to the circles. What are the circles? I will give you second question. Are in the ratio 2:1. 2:1 minus 2x plus 4y minus 20 is equal to 0. Minus 2x minus 8y plus 1 equal. So this is the second question. Second sum. Okay, circles 2:1 ratio, find log sum. So not find log sum P. Here then show that same way you have to do here. I'm giving answer also. Then so that the locus of P is, locus of P is x square plus y square minus 2x, x square plus y square minus 2x minus 12y plus 8 equal to 0. Just take this is S and this is S dash. Length of tangent is root S. That S double up S11. This length of the second one is root S dash for 1 is equal to 2:1. And doing the product of extents equal product of means and simplify, we get the answer. Okay? So answer will be x square plus y square minus 2x minus 4y plus 8 equal to 0. Same way. So, okay, if you have any doubt, so we give you one more question. Third one I am going to explain. Same concept. So listen, next third question also, same question, the lengths of tangents, first write down question, otherwise take a screenshot. Okay, our next sum is okay. 8x plus 2y plus 15, 8x 2y plus 15, third question, and minus 4x minus 6y minus 4. The length of tangent drawn from P to the circuits so and so are equal, then find locus of P. See here, the lengths of two circles are equal, means what? Yes, root S11 is equal to root S dash 11. Okay, so given that here, lengths of tangents are equal. I think if you understand, you can do the problem. Just pause the video, you do it after that, verify with me. So here I am doing, so first given that, first letter P, x1 comma y1 is A, is a point of required locus, and S I am taking for circle, as 15 equal 0, so I get 2 1 by data. And second one I'm taking s dash, that is x square plus y square minus 4x minus x y minus 12 equal to 0. So don't take one is s1, one is s2. S1 means here different. X x1, y1 like x minus 2. Use it for equation of tan in that way. Okay? So take first s, second s dash, third one is there s double dash. What is given? Given that lengths are tangents are equal. So you can write a root s11 is equal to root s11 dash. Or another way also you can write equal means ratio are equal. So equal means ratio are equal. Root s11 is to root s dash 11 equal to 1 is to 1 also you can take and you can do. In the next step you have same step you get. But this is your direct simply you can write. What is root? Now to remove square what I'm doing? To remove square root, squaring on both sides. Squaring on both sides. So root s11 square becomes what? Only s11. This is called root s1, s11 dash becomes s11 dash. Now tell me what is s11? So directly s11 is x square plus y square, sorry, x1 square, y1 square plus 8x1 plus 12y1 plus 15. This is called x1 square plus y1 square minus 4x1 minus 6y1 minus 12. And that's s11 equal to s11 dash. Same terms the left side and right side get be cancelled. And remaining terms here 8x1, here 12y1 plus 15. So bring the right side terms to left side, minus 4x1 minus 6 plus 4x1. And plus 6y1 minus plus 12 is equal to. So now tell me how many x1 terms are there? Here 8, here 4, totally 12 x1 terms. And what about y1 terms? Here 12, here 6, totally 18 y1 terms. And what about constant? 15 are there, 12 are there, totally 27. Anything common? Each and every term. Yes, 3 is common. So in 3 table, 3, 4, ja, 6, 1, 3, 6, ja, and 3, 9. So therefore, locus of point P is what? Now write down without 2, x from right. Means 4x plus 6y plus 9 equal 0. Okay friends, this is the third question. Answer. Okay, we just learn only 3 questions. Next 4th onwards we can learn in the next part. So those 4 questions, 4 mass questions will be like how to find circle equation when x intercept or y intercept is given, and the very most important question is how to find the length of chord. Okay, so that is very most important. 99% that is repeated in the exam so many times. So in the next parts we have very very most important questions are there. So please watch our next class immediately. So thank you for watching our classes regularly. Again I am saying, if you are newly watching, please hit the bell button before after subscribing, and also please click the like button, give comments. Thank you.